Hello everyone. So today we will start with a new chapter, that is spreadsheet intermediate. It is included in your board exam as well as in the post midterm. So basically you all are aware with spreadsheet. Spreadsheet is means where the data which are arranged in the form of table, or you can say rows and column. Okay, you already have learned how to work on spreadsheet. We have done in class 9 also. Now use autosum in cells. Now what is autosum, student? This is autosum is a useful function of Excel or some other spreadsheet program. What it does actually, it add the values automatically. Okay. So enter automatically once you click on auto sum, then automatically it enters the appropriate formula or function into your spreadsheet. Now here are steps has been given here how to implement auto sum. So you just and the keyboard shortcut is also given for auto sum is alt plus equals to is equals to. If you will give it will enter the formula of autosum. Okay, means you need not have to write is equals to then sum then individually cell. You need not have to click to find the sum of the data. Just by clicking autosum it will give you the sum of the all the data the with by which you want. Okay, now here summary auto sum option is available in the editing group. Student, these all things you have to go through. I already mentioned. Okay, then the little black square at the bottom right corner of active cell is called autofill handle. What happened whenever we entered in a cell, we entered any formula in a cell, and after giving enter we see that a small at the corner right corner of that cell we see a small square, black square. So that is known as autofill handle. Okay, now MCQ you have to do in copy and both do the this question number 1 from B in your copy. All right, next is conditional formatting. What is conditional formatting? It is also a very nice feature in Excel and spreadsheet program that allows us to apply specific format to a cell or a range of cells in the basis of specified condition. What happened? Conditional formatting is useful when you work on a huge amount of data and want to highlight some specific cells. Like for example, like we have a list of students along with their marks. Now I want to mark those students with red color or those who got less than 40. All right, so for that, and I want to highlight those with some color, so for that we use conditional formatting. Here is the steps for conditional formatting. Just go through these steps. Okay, and the number format, font, fill color, border color, all these things we can apply with conditional formatting. Okay, now next is here all is given that I will once the will be able to do in practical. I'll show you in the practical also that how these things happen. Now MCQ you have to do, and both the questions you have to do from this. Okay, now next is hide, unhide, freeze rows and column. So hiding means if you want to hide any row and column, you simply in the format cells home tab, you just there you will see hide, unhide. You will just simply you will click hide, then that row or column will be hidden. And if you will once you will hide, then you will see that unhide option is also there. Then you can unhide your hidden row or column. Okay, now freeze. What happen in case of freeze? Freezing or unfreezing rows or column or both. If you have long rows or column of data that extend beyond the viewable area of the sheet, यू कैन फ्रीज सम रोज और कॉलम और बोथ विच अलाउ यू टू सी द फ्रोजन कॉलम्स और रोज एज यू वॉन्ट टू फ्रीज और अनफ्रीज. सो टू फ्रीज एंड अनफ्रीज द रो फॉलोइंग आर द गिवन स्टेप्स. Freeze means what happens, students? Sometimes there is a large number of data and it's very difficult for to scroll each and every data. All right. So the where you will freeze those panes, then you need not have to scroll since till the end. For that, till that it will remain fixed, and after that rest you can scroll down. So that is the work of the freeze pen. Okay, and again once you freeze it, you can also unfreeze it. Once you freeze it, you can also unfreeze that row or column. Okay, so here are some steps for freezing rows and column, and to unfreeze. Okay, now see, unfreeze rows and column. So unfreeze means to unfreeze, click on view freeze panes, then unfreeze panes. So how, when you will freeze pane, automatically unfreeze pane will also appear, then you can easily unfreeze it. So summary you have to go through, and multiple choice question also you have to do. You have to do and do the question answers, and most probably in the next class I may show you these things over the Google Meet. Okay, thank you.